Watching the On the Road edition of WatchGuard Security Week in Review, a video podcast dedicated to quickly summarizing the biggest information and network security stories each week. I'm Corey Nachreiner, your host, and this is the episode for the week starting April 16th, 2012. This week I've been traveling, giving security talks at various events such as the U.S. Embassy in Copenhagen and the ICT Expo in Helsinki, Finland, so this episode comes from my hotel here in Helsinki. Let's jump right into this shortened episode with three big security stories from this week. The first big story of the month is Oracle's quarterly patch day. This week, Oracle released their CPU, or critical patch update, for Monday. This is a package that contains patches for many, many Oracle products. Some ones they fixed this month includes Oracle Database, Oracle Application Server, Oracle JDeveloper, Oracle MySQL, and many, many other Oracle products. This particular update fixes 88 vulnerabilities in all those products. The vulnerabilities differ greatly in their scope and impact, but some of them are very, very critical. A few of them have a CVSS score of 10 and basically allow a remote, unauthenticated attacker to gain access to your database server. So if you're an Oracle administrator, you definitely want to go check out Oracle's CPU update for April 2012. Another big news story was the discovery of yet another big Mac Trojan. This one's called SabPub, and there's a little confusion over how it infects Mac users. Most of the research I read says it comes as a malicious Word document exploiting an old Word vulnerability, very similar to that other Word Mac Trojan I talked about a few months ago. However, other researchers are claiming that SabPub also exploited the same Java flaw that Flashback malware exploited. In either case, there is definitely a new variant of this Word Trojan that came out probably sometime in late March, so it's just another Trojan for Mac users to worry about. So again, if you're a Mac user, you should definitely be concerned about security. I'd recommend trying out Little Snitch, a great Mac firewall, and I believe Sophos offers a free Mac antivirus client, which you might try as well. The final security story this week is Google using its power for good. This week, Google warned around 20,000 websites that they'd been booby-trapped with infected JavaScript code. It's very common for attackers to leverage web application flaws and inject legitimate websites with JavaScript redirection code, typically some code that will redirect their visitors to some malicious drive-by download site. Well, Google's search engine is able to detect some of this malicious JavaScript in many websites, so they went ahead and warned around 20,000 of those web owners that they were infected by this JavaScript. While many security experts are often concerned about all the privacy risk with sharing so much information with Google, it's good to see that Google's still using their power for good in some cases. Well, that's it for this week's shortened on-the-road version of WatchGuard Security Week in Review. Next week, I'll return to more regular episodes from the office. Until then, be sure to check me out on Twitter. I'm at SecAdept. Thanks for watching, and as always, WatchGuard's rooting for you.